Rodney, thanks for sitting down and talking with us. You know, you go for 7 years in the league and able to play every game, and all of a sudden you get hurt last season.
Yeah.
How big of an adjustment was that for you?
That was a huge adjustment, having the game taken away from me just in a split second. You know, you always talk about it, but you never think it's actually going to happen to you. And, you know, when it does, you know, how are you going to respond, right? And so it was rough in the beginning, of course, not being out on the field, not being able to be vocal for my guys, not feeling a part of the team. But one thing that, you know, we have here, man, is a brotherhood, and they found a way to rally behind me and make me still feel a part. And that was big in getting through the rehab process. So I credit, you know, a lot of these guys, and then of course my support system back at home. But missed the game a lot, and I'm just happy, man. It's hard for me not to walk out that locker room any day with a smile on my face now, being back out there.
What was the biggest part, the physical part or just the mental part, and dealing with all the mental aspects of
rehab? I think it was the mental part, and kind of going through the day-to-day grind and trying to get back, but you're not seeing the results that you want right away, right? And you're just working constantly and you're not getting the results. You're not seeing it, but you just got to trust it.
Right.
And, you know, that's what I had to do. I had to set short-term goals for myself to get myself through. I was writing down my emotions on paper, you know, so that I wasn't lashing out, you know, at times at home.
That's
good. I mean, it's hard, man, when something that you love so much is now taken away from you. And, you know, you got to cope with that. And so I talked to Carson. I talked to guys like Chris Maragos, who used to be on the team. And, you know, they kind of gave me some advice. So I listened to those guys, and it kind of helped me out a lot.
How much fun was it when you finally got back on the field and felt like Rodney of old?
It felt great. Because it took so long to get to that point. Even when I was back out there, there still was just something different, and I wasn't necessarily feeling like myself. So I would like pinpoint, you know, Baltimore game as like that last step that I kind of needed to check that box. Like, I think I've finally taken that step. I've arrived, and I feel like, you know, myself a couple years ago.
Let's go back to Sunday night's game against the Falcons. Tough loss, very tough. You had a different role, I thought, in that game, where you got a lot of opportunities to blitz the quarterback and insert it in ways that I haven't seen before. How much did you like that role?
I liked it a lot. It kind of allowed me to be everywhere. My presence, you know, is in the back end, middle of the field. I take pride in that, and I own that role. But it was good just to move around a little bit, get active, you know what I'm saying, in the blitz game. Cover some guys. It kept me involved in every way, and man, I loved it. I was just flying around trying to make plays. So hoping, you know, Jim Schwartz dials up some more blitzes for me as, you know, we got the turnover off it. So I'm looking forward to that. We'll see what we got cooked up this week.
You got the turnover. Darby gets the interception. Do you get an assist? Do you get credit? Do you get to carry the ball home for the day?
I told him, I said, hey, you owe me half of that, whatever that means. I'm probably just looking for the end of the year reward, you know, when you get that big deal, you know, getting half of that. But no, it felt good, man, and us applying that pressure, being aggressive and seeing guys like him, you know, make plays because we really needed turnovers. We preached that, and first week we came up short. We didn't play like ourselves, came back this next week with that focus and mindset that we got to go in there, we got to create turnovers, get the ball back to our offense.
Many people talk about Jim Schwartz wanting to see him blitz more. It's a game where you blitzed a lot, but in the end, it was the blitz that kind of hurt you with the play to Julio Jones. How do you balance that?
You know, we look at that play and we learn from it, right? And you know, we're aggressive style defense. Jim Schwartz is not going to change who he is, and we're not going to change who we are. We just got to understand, you know, when a team is in a situation where they've seen it so much and now they have an opportunity to call an audible, we have to adjust with them. You got to play that mind game, right? And so I think that's the next step that we have to take as a group, as a defense, because, you know, that's going to come up again, right? It's going to come down the line and we're going to be facing number 12, Tom Brady, and he's going to adjust. So it's got to be a chess match. So I think we take it to that next step and we'll be fine.
How much fun is it for you to quarterback the back end of that defense? I see the communication between you and Malcolm in that whole secondary.
Yeah.
How much fun is that?
It's a lot of fun. And I think it's good, man. You have Malcolm, you know, the general who's down there usually quarterbacking things down there closer to the line of scrimmage. And then you have me in the back end with the experience and the chemistry that we have amongst the group. We see everything the same. We've been playing with each other for a long time. So I'm just excited, man, for this group. And you see a lot of guys stepping up in a major way for us. Sidney Jones getting his first pick last week. So it feels good, man. Be an older guy in the bunch now. And I remember when I caught my first interception. So I was reflecting on that. But it's good. It's good.
Looking at Sunday, Matthew Stafford. Big challenge because a veteran guy, but he also has some young, sharp weapons around him, the tight end and running backs. Tell us a little bit about that challenge coming up this weekend.
Yeah, Matthew Stafford, he's seen a lot, played a lot of ball in this league, you know, gets a lot of respect around the league. Gunslinger, gets the ball out very quick. So it's going to be a challenge for us to play tight coverage in the back end, to give our D-line an opportunity, take away his first reads in order for them to make plays. So like I said, you know, it's going to be a tough task on us. They got a real good running back, a couple good young players. I'm going to dial in and got to get on that tape, man. We pride ourselves on preparation. So got to study up, get some tendencies. But like I said, tight coverage is going to be the key.
You're back in the win column this weekend?
Absolutely. We're back at home, man. We got to show out. You know, we weren't really proud of our performance. We came out with the victory the first week, but we feel like we got to get these fans what they want, and defense is going to show up.